Until now, to install a Home Assistant OS on your Raspberry Pi 4 or 400 device requires you to have another computer. On this another computer, you have to perform several steps to prepare your future Raspberry Pi storage, and only after that you are able to continue the installation on the Raspberry Pi. All of that is not needed anymore, as you can now install any supported OS, including Home Assistant OS, on your Raspberry Pi device over the network. The network installer will start a Raspberry Pi imager application, which will run in memory on your Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi imager can be then used to flash the operating system onto a blank SD card or USB disk, just like normal. Here are the requirements for that. First, you need to have a Raspberry Pi 4 or Raspberry Pi 400. I know that Raspberry Pi 4 are hard to find lately, and you have to be patient or lucky or both to find one. But I believe this will be over soon and it will be back to normal. And next requirement is to have the latest stable Raspberry Pi bootloader. If you don't have it, you can update it using few simple commands that you can find in the video description or in my written article available on my website. A monitor is also required, just initially during the installation process, and afterwards you can remove it and continue headless. After that, you will need a freshly formatted SD card or compatible USB drive, like some fast SSD drive or USB flash drive. And finally, you will need an Ethernet cable with internet access, as well as one USB keyboard. The keyboard is only needed if you are using Raspberry Pi 4. For Pi 400, apparently you already have that included. I will leave some affiliate links in the video description for the things that I'm using. And if you buy something from these links, I'll receive a small commission with no additional cost for you. Now, let's begin installing the Home Assistant OS on a Raspberry Pi 4 over the network. Okay, I connected the LAN cable. You're going to need to physically connect your Raspberry Pi to your router via an Ethernet cable rather than connecting it to your wireless network. You can configure your wireless network and remove the cable once you have Home Assistant OS up and running, and I'll show you that later. The keyboard, this is the monitor, and now I'll power on the Raspberry Pi. Like that. This is an empty SD card, freshly formatted. I'll hold down the shift key now. Let me adjust the camera so you can see the full screen. And this is the Raspberry Pi imager. From here I can choose an OS. Now is the time to choose your operating system. I want the Home Assistant OS, which is one of the official methods to get Home Assistant. But if you want to learn more about the other three official methods that are available, plus one secret and super easy way to have Home Assistant in under 5 minutes, you can go and check my webinar. The webinar is completely free, and you can reserve your place by registering at automatelike.pro/webinar. Now, let's continue with the installation of the Home Assistant OS on a Raspberry Pi 4 over the network. Other specific purpose OS. Home Assistants and Home Automation, this is the category that I need. And here it is, Home Assistant. I'll select the Home Assistant for Raspberry Pi 4/400. I'll choose the storage, this is my internal SD card, and I'll click on the right button. All existing data will be erased. Are you sure? Yes, I am. And the writing is started. And the writing of Home Assistant OS is almost done. 99, 100. Verifying. I can even cancel the verifying, but I'll leave it like that. Sorry for this label right here. It is from the monitor. Somehow the volume down button is pressed all the time, and this right here is a banner from the monitor, and I cannot remove it. The verifying is done, and now the Raspberry Pi is restarted. I hope to see Home Assistant OS. Something is loading, but I'm not sure yet what it is. From what I can see here, it is Home Assistant OS, Network Manager, Has OS. Everything seems fine so far. Waiting for the Home Assistant CLI to be ready. Great! And just like that, I have a Home Assistant running on my Raspberry Pi 4 in several minutes using the network installer. I can try to open the Home Assistant .local:8123 as a port. And here it is, preparing Home Assistant. This can take up to 20 minutes.
A few moments later.
And this is the onboarding screen of Home Assistant, where I can set my username and password like that. I can alternatively restore from a backup if I happen to have one using this link right here, but I'll skip that and I'll click Create Account. I can name my home, for example, Home Test. I can select my location, I can choose my time zone. I can select my unit system and the currency. I'll leave everything as is, and I'll click Next. I'll enable this diagnostic data. It is anonymized, and this helps convincing big vendors that a lot of people are using Home Assistant. So I prefer to enable this, but you can choose otherwise, of course, it's up to you. And I'll click Next. These are some of the auto discovery integrations that I have, but I'll skip these and I'll just click Finish. And here it is. This is the Home Assistant main screen. Congratulations! Home Assistant OS is now installed on a Raspberry Pi 4 using a network installer. The next step is optional. You can connect your Raspberry Pi to a Wi-Fi and go wireless, or you can leave the Ethernet cable connected. The choice is yours. If possible, I can recommend to choose the wired connection, as it is still more reliable than the Wi-Fi in most of the cases. I'll press the C button on my keyboard and I'll start type network. And I'll select navigate network. I'll select this WLAN 0 tab and I'll expand the Wi-Fi, scan for access points. This is my Wi-Fi, I'll select it, and I'll scroll down, I'll select WPA PSK, and I'll type my password. Then I'll hit save. If you're changing the Wi-Fi, IP or gateway, you may lose connection. If I refresh the screen and if I go to the WLAN 0 tab again, and if I expand the Wi-Fi, I'll see connected to A. This is my Wi-Fi network. And the final thing that I have to do is to expand this IPv4 and to select DHCP here. Then I'll click Save. And I can disconnect the physical cable and go wireless. Let's try this. And I'm ready! Now I have to log into my router to see what's my newly assigned IP. I found it. My IP is 13. This is my Wi-Fi IP. Everything stays the same and it is working. Now I can type my username and I can log in. And now I'm wirelessly connected to my home network. When you have Home Assistant up and running on a Raspberry Pi, you can start making your dream smart home. If you don't know what is possible, check some of my videos in my Home Assistant playlist that I'll link right here. Don't forget to subscribe for my newsletter at payansky.com/newsletter if you want to receive new smart home and Home Assistant content on a weekly basis. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!